up, people? It is me, Tasha. I am back. You see the title of the video. Yes, we're doing it. Just a good old flashback of years before when we used to recap and review shows here on Tasha TV. And we are back to review season 9 of BT Sunday Best. I'm excited. I'm excited for the season. I'm excited to be back on YouTube. Thank you guys for coming back. I hope that you hit that like button. I hope that you hit that subscribe button. If you unsubscribed or you're resubscribing, or if you're new, do what you need to do down there and let's engage and get in the comments and talk about the latest episode of season 9 BT Sunday Best. The promos got me. They have done a good job of promoting the show and I'm here for it. I'm ready to see Fantasia. I'm ready to hear what some of the judges are going to be saying and doing on the show. I am excited, you guys, all right? So if you don't know, BET Sunday Best, it is a gospel singing competition show. Similar a little bit to like The Voice, X Factor, and American Idol. But the difference, and the greatest difference for me personally, is that it is centered around the gospel. This is a ministry thing. If you're a believer, it's a wonderful time to just kick back and see what these young people, older people, whoever people are doing with, you know, their faith and their ministry and their faith walk, basically. So I love it. There's excellent praise breaks that are in here. You get some excellent singing because these people are skilled in what they do. All right. So not only is there an entertainment level with it, but there's the added bonus of a ministry that's in there. So you're going to be encouraged. You're going to be motivated. You're going to be inspired. And that is why I love Sunday Best. It's one of the better singing competition shows that are out now. This year, contestants could audition online by sending in a video. And also, they went and flew out some people, you know, to go to different countries to look for talent and everything. So we're international now with Sunday Best. And I like that. I think that's awesome and amazing because, you know, as the gospel reaches the ends of the earth, why not this show? So let's get into it. You guys know from the gate already how I roll. If you've watched the previous reviews that I've done, you know I already have people that I'm rooting for to win. One person in particular that we'll talk about right now because I missed his live audition on this show, so I had to look it up via social media, and thank God for social media that I got to see it. Melvin Crispell III. I was excited to know that he was going to be on the show. He came to my praise and worship leader, Isaiah Templeton. You guys make sure you go and get his album. It's called This Life Is Out There Right Now. Anyway, he came to my praise and worship leader's album release concert, and they did a mic toss, and Isaiah gave the mic to Melvin and killed it. I mean, probably a minute that he sang, and I was like, whoa. I haven't had the privilege of listening and hearing from Melvin before, but he's huge here in Charlotte, so I need to get on the ball and be learning some people. But when I heard that he was going to be on this season of Sunday Best, I was like, yep, Team Melvin, he's going to win. Because I've heard, you know, what he's done, and he has a huge following. So when it comes time for us to vote, which I really do think that they are going to let us vote, listen, we're going in, okay? We are going in for Melvin over here, all right? Let's talk about the new judges. We have new judges, people. All right, so first, Erica Campbell is coming back. You know, she's not with Tina. Well, Tina's not on the show. I'm not saying she's not with Tina. But Tina's not on the show, but I like Erica Campbell. I think she's cool. She does it all at radio host, could judge for this TV show. She's first lady. She's an artist. She's a mom. She's a wife. I don't know when she sleeps, but I like Erica. She's entertaining to me. She gives great advice, and she's just all around just a cool chick. So we have two new judges. Judge number one that's coming new is Jonathan McReynolds, and I like having him on the show. I was kind of a little iffy about it at first, but I think that he's going to bring a lot of good advice to the table. I can kind of see him, you know, blending the whole entertainer part of it with the ministry part, and you know how to make that more fluid for the contestants. Also giving them a lot of technical advice too as well. So I like having Jonathan McReynolds on here. But Kelly Price is on the show. Now I know, because I've been seeing the jokes and I've been hearing what you guys are saying. I know Kelly's kind of been up and down a little bit throughout the years. Some people don't really care for her because of the other reality show that she's done. I didn't watch it, so seeing her fresh on this show, I love her. She's giving me everything that I need, from facial expressions to challenging people, you know, to do better, giving them another chance. And I think she gives great advice. I see her as the technical judge. She's going to be able to tell people how you hone your skills and how you hone your artistry to be the more so, not just the blending of the ministry side, but more so of the entertaining side. Because let's just be honest, we're people, we're humans, you know. The ministry part of it is great and it's excellent, but you got to be able to execute it really well. Okay, what's going to grab people's attention? What's going to hold their attention? And what's going to make them remember you when you leave the stage? You know what I'm saying? So I think Kelly Price is going to be really good in that format. Talk about some of the contestants. Who were some of you guys' favorite contestants? Leave those comments down below. Whose team are you on? Who are your faves right now? So some of my faves, Opal Staples. She came out and she did Pass Me Not. Yeah, I think it's a Pass Me Not. Pass Me Not, Oh Gentle Savior. I like a lot of hymns were sung during the audition series too as well. So, but I like her voice. I think she has a great tone. I think there's a lot more that she's going to give us. So, it's just my excitement of what's to come is one of the reasons why Opal was one of my favorite people. So let's talk about the Barnes sisters. They auditioned in the second half of the premiere, and it's Ashley and Chelsea Barnes. And I'm gonna let you know right now, I am team Chelsea. All right, Chelsea to me, I kind of felt her a little bit more. Ashley is really good too. These two sisters, they're viral. So they do videos and you can probably look them up on YouTube and everything. But yeah, I enjoy Chelsea more. So I'm with Kelly Price. I hope that it comes down to a Venus and Serena type kind of match. And I think the show should pit them two together. You know, just pit them against each other to see who's going to win. Because only one person is going to win this competition, all right? And speaking of winning the competition, this year is $50,000 on the line, as well as a recording contract with RCA Inspiration. Oh, Tiffany Moore, she came out and she sang God Provides. This is why I like Sunday best, because it's not just good singing. It's a message and it's an inspiration. It's motivation. And it was a great reminder for me personally that the song that she sang, Tamela Mann, God Provides, that song comes on in. Yes, Tamela sings it very well. I love to hear her sing it. I love to hear other people sing it, but it's the lyrics that get me. That song is one of my personal favorites because it got me through some hard times, you know, a few years ago. And it was just a great reminder that even though it may not be the way that we think it should go or the way we want it to go, God definitely does provide for you. And you have to be grateful and thankful for that. And I enjoyed hearing Tiffany sing that. When she sang it, though, I was also in a mode of like, wow, I really want to go to her church and you know, see her in her element, in her environment. So I like that too. That's another thing about Sunday Best that I like. I'm looking forward to everything. There's going to be guest judges on the show. I think I saw Kiki Wyatt. Pastor Shirley Caesar is going to be there. Fantasia is going to perform. I believe Donald Lawrence is going to be there as well. I think, I don't know, maybe this was just a flashback. I think it was just a flashback. I thought Kiara Shear was going to be on there too, but I don't know. You never know with the different things that are going on, who's going to be there. So I'm excited. Oh, no, listen, 20 people audition, only 10 are going to next week. All right. So the 10 that we have next week, Melvin Crispell III, Tiffany Andrews, Joshua Copeland, Keela Richardson, Chelsea Barnes, Linda Williams, who reminds me of Mama Sue. Y'all remember Mama Sue? She's our church mother this season. Opal Staples, Tiffany Moore, Lakeisha Rice, and Ashley Barnes is coming through. All right, so my favorites. Team Melvin, I think he's going to win. That is who I think is going to win. I'm also going to enjoy the competition of Opal Staples, and I'm going for Chelsea Barnes with the sister versus sister. With the sister versus sister thing. Tiffany Andrews, I didn't see her. Did I see Tiffany's audition? See, listen, I got satellite, okay? And we had a storm that rolled through right as the show was coming on. So my satellite was like, we're not doing it today. So I missed a few auditions, but that's my top three. I'm going with them. Melvin for the win, and then I think Opal Staples, you know, she might make top three. That's what I'm thinking. And then I like Chelsea. I don't know if Chelsea's going to make top three, but I think she will be in the top five because I'm going with Chelsea over Ashley. And then Tiffany Moore, we'll see where she fits in it. She might be top five too. All right. So yeah. But I'm Team Melvin. Who's on your team? Who are you choosing, all right, to be? You put that down below in the comments. We like to lock them in early, all right? If you don't want to lock in early right now, you got to lock in by next week, okay? Because we go from 10, I think we'll go down to 6. I'm not totally sure, but I think they're going down to 6. But let's have a fun time engaging with each other and talking about this show. I'm excited to be back, and, you know, we'll make cool videos and, I don't know. We'll see what happens. You know what I'm saying? Anyway, I love you guys. God loves you. Make sure you guys like, subscribe, comment down below. You can follow me on social media at It's Me Tasha. That's me on Twitter. That's also me on Instagram. And if you're on my Facebook, cool. We cool. We friends. All right. I love you guys. I gotta go. I will see you next week. Thanks for tuning in. Bye. Deuces.